Now question is a copper wire of length. So copper wire length LC is equal to 2.2 meter, right? And a steel wire of length, so LS is equal to 1.6 meter, both of diameter 3 mm are connected end to end. So both have diameters DC and DS is equal to, both are same and it is 3 into 10 raised to minus 3 meter, are connected end to end when stretched by a load, right? The net elongation is found to be, so here delta LC plus delta LS is 0.7 into 10 raised to minus 3 because the sum of this elongation are delta LC plus delta LS. Obtain the load applied. Young modulus is given, and young modulus of steel, steel and copper both are given, right? Now see here, for first copper, YC is equal to stress F upon A upon delta LC upon LC, right? See here, for both copper and steel, F upon A is common, right? So we can write YC into delta LC upon LC is equal to YS into delta LS upon LS, right? See, now we don't have this value, so by this equation we can find delta LC upon delta LS, right? So whatever we get value, we can put in the other equation. This is our another equation, right? And we can find the one, right? And another, see, whenever we found any one of them, we can find this one also, because if delta LC we got, then LC also we have from this F upon A, right? So see, A is pi r square, so diameter is given also, because r, radius is equal to diameter by 2, right? And YC and YS both are given. So by putting all the values, we can find here force, which is nothing but load of applied here, right?